say. Now everyone's gonna think that I hate him, and I was like, well, you do hate him. Like, why are you so mad about it? And Anthony came up to me and said, I know you don't like me, but you didn't have to say it on the radio. And I just kind of looked at Sully, and I was like, yeah, we did. I needed everybody to know. But we've done a lot together, I think, especially on the radio, where I pretty much had to hold myself back from swearing all the time. And because I'm a stand-up comedian, that's what I do. I have a band, and I was telling Big O before we came back in here.
The director now. Sorry.
That my show gets so bad sometimes, even in bars, that I have to put signs up saying that you have to be 18 to be able to come in. And our tickets sell for like $20, so if somebody buys a ticket for $20 and they bring somebody who's under 18, and I'm going to feel bad because they pretty much wasted their money. So that's a sincere moment, by the way. That's just sincere. I'm usually never sincere, but there you go.
Yeah, they used to be kind of a little chunky, and you lost a lot of weight. How did you do it?
I was 240 pounds May 1st. I was huge. Wow. Yeah, I was huge.
Were you gagging yourself? Or were you on a diet, exercising, or just stress?
A lot of placing fingers into my mouth. And
eggnog competitions.
Eggnog competitions, yeah, right. That's right.
Which we have, right?
We have it.
Unless Joe went over and needed it somehow, whenever I wasn't looking.
Does it? It smells
okay,
like...
Okay, now you're just... Sully, I thought we were past this.
Did you even smell this?
I did smell it.
It smells like booze. It smells like booze.
I smell it from here.
It smells like alcohol.
And
are you sure you got non-alcoholic eggnog?
I promise I did. I promise. It's regular, straight-up eggnog. There's no alcohol.
Nog is tough stuff, man.
I know it is. It's very thick.
What's it made out of?
It reminds me of something, which is why I thought it would not only be seasonal, to have some eggnog, but it reminds me of a certain bodily fluid, and watching those girls chug on that sort of really excited me, and I'm not going to lie. Obviously, Annie and Carly, it's all about me and my sexual pleasure. Annie, your dad knows I'm a whack job, so let's get that out of the way right now.
I feel so bad for Dave right now.
Why do you feel bad for Dave, Don?
I'm part of this segment now, Sully.
You are part of it. I never said you weren't.
Yes, but...
But why do you feel bad for Dave, Don?
Because his facial expressions are just like, why am I here right now?
I was okay until then, Sully. You really lost me there.
I'm
going to have to edit that part out.
Hey, that's Big O's job. Let's hope that Big O doesn't accidentally delete the whole show when he first comes to edit. I'm just hoping that doesn't happen, honestly. But Joe, like I said, don't worry about it. I'll have you back, but if it happens again, I'm going to have to let you go. Because I can't afford for this to happen again. You understand?
And I will still be the director of BPTV, either way.
So
that's something we're going to have to live with.
Yeah.
So you take absolutely no blame for what happened?
Absolutely not, so.
And he should.
I was in the room. If there's questions that need to be asked, I was there to be asked.
Your apology is accepted, don't worry.
Joe, are you just intimidated by Dave?
No, there was no apology. Absolutely none.
A little bit. He's kind of unflappable.
He really does have a dry sense of humor. Mm. But I'm not gonna hold that
really
against
dry.
The man. Because
well, my IQ is obviously not high enough to understand that humor. So
what kind of humor?
The dry humor?
Yeah, usually dry humor is really intellectual, which I'm not. So, I'm pretty much funny to stupid people like you. And...
tell the people, how did you go about portraying Santa? Because they obviously can't see it. So, what did we talk about, Don? You tell
I was
them what went on. What did they miss? What are they missing? Not
you
much,
were missing
right?
a drunk, alcoholic Santa Claus who got arrested by the Bethel Park Police Department for mooning cars. And I pretty much told all the kids off. I admitted that I had a black wife.
Half black.
I think it's Michelle Obama.
Yeah. Is she half black?
No, she's all black.
She's all she's the all dark mate.
Trust me.
And I was hitting on Annie for a little bit, and then
and that made Annie puke some more eggnog up even more.
She liked it. Come here and give Santa Claus
a
little
kissy. She has her
head
in her hands, and I see water coming down her face.
Are you crying?
I have water doesn't come down my face.
Yeah, I don't know. They probably can't even hear Annie, can they?
No.
Poor Annie. Joe, all right, what do you have to say? Joe, in all serious right now, Joe, God, this falls on me, I mean, this is not you. This is me. No, because people will not say, Joe Krasinski messed up. They're going to say,
Wait,
the Sully show was...
What's your last? I'm sorry. That's more. Your last name is more important here. What's your last name?
Krabzinski.
Krabzinski. Krabzinski.
It's K-R-A-F.
Mike Bazowski. It reminds me of Monsters, Inc.
I'm not trying to sound selfish, but no one really is going to say Joe messed up. They're going to say the Sully show wasn't that great this time around because we didn't see Santa. So this is going to fall on me, you know. Like, if Don came on here and started swearing, or if Dave came on here and started beating me up, that would fall on me because it's the Sully, it's Sully show.
Yeah, it's true.
Because you want to. No, it's the Sully show. So this is all going to fall on me. So on that note, what do you have to say for yourself?
I think we already went through this, didn't we?
I'm going to go through it again.
All right. I would like to offer some words of inspiration for both myself and for the rest of the crew for next time around.
Talk about beating a dead
prostitute.
Can I get the mic?
No, that's mine.
All right.
He thinks he's Larry King. Sorry.
All right. Retired.
He's doing stand-up comedy, which I don't understand, but go ahead.
Me?
No, Larry King.
I was going to say, you're not very funny, Joe. In fact, you made me cry, if anything.
Thanks.
All right. No, okay.
You're more of the Titanic of comedy.
It's you, all right,
I know. These are words of inspiration, not just for the Sully show, but for everybody, all over. Sons of Gondor, of Rohan, my brothers.
The guy's in the back saying, shut up.
Bigger doesn't want me to do.
Was that your idea? Was that your idea of calling?
Hold on.
Joe messed up so badly that Big O, who is my right hand man in this whole entire process and has been for the past 3 years, is directing right now. Annie, who has been my 2 years, but my lovely female sidekick, is sitting in a chair about to vomit right now.
Yes.
All thanks to you, Joe. So on that note, what do you have to say?
There may come a day when the courage of men fails, when we forsake our brothers and break all bonds of fellowship, but it is not this day. An hour of wolves and shattered shields when the age of men comes crashing down, but it is not this day. This day we fight. By all that you hold dear on this good earth, I bid you stand, men of the West.
I'm gonna walk off when I want to walk off, Dave Cable. I am done.
Not to ruin your big moment.
That was about as big as
Thank you. Let's give a round of applause. I don't even know where that quote is recited from.
I think it was Lord of the Rings, because I just watched it the other day because I was bored.
Lord of the Rings.
That was Lord of the Rings.
Wonderful. So we're off to a wonderful start. How
Great.
Would you rate that, Mr. Cable? Although you just asked me to not call you that, but I kind of like it.
All right.
So, how would you rate that performance?
A zero.
I'm not talking numbers. I'm talking about, letters.
Oh, letters? I guess
I was actually asking Dave, but you can hog some of the spotlight.
No, go ahead, Dave, by all means.
I'd give it a B. It was a solid delivery. I mean, everything else he did today was terrible, but that delivery was fantastic. All
right. Go ahead, Don.
That was awesome. That was pure gold. Yeah, obviously, it was pure gold. I would rate it a C+.
C+?
Mostly for, I'll give him an A for effort for remembering that. That was pretty, but I'll give him a D for being such a nerd for remembering.
All kidding aside, Joe, don't worry about it. We're going to have you back on, and you're invited to come out to dinner with us after the show. So wonderful job, everyone. Thanks,
I won't
everyone.
Be going to dinner now because of this, but it's okay.
I'll be back after this to wrap the show. Thank God.
All right.
Welcome back to the Sully Show. It's been one heck of a Christmas special, I would
Crazy
say.
Crazy Christmas special.
Not only did we record two or three segments we thought we recorded that didn't record, but without that happening, we wouldn't have had the brilliance of a Joe Krabzinski getting mad and leaving.
Good.
No, he seriously is gone. We have not seen him. We don't know where he is.
He totally stormed out of here.
Dave was pretty good, too.
Dave was funny.
Dave was funny.
I enjoyed it. He was like at the end of the day.
Do you think that
might have
been
BBTV
actually better than
beautiful.
Santa? No offense.
No, he was about it. No, Santa was way better.
Bro, you're supposed to lie and say.
Dry humor is pretty good, but you know Dave's about as dry as a towel. So.
Well, yeah, I mean, but.
He's probably back there shaking his head right now.
But Don, thank you very much for driving all the way over here from Altoona. I thanked you about 4 times, but I can't thank you enough, buddy.
That's all right. You gave me $10.
Very funny in town. Guy, Carly, thanks for going through the eggnog chugging. I mean, are you still feeling sick?
I'm just happy you lost the Santa Claus thing and not the chugging footage, because I wasn't doing that.
Because you would have kicked my.
I wouldn't.
We would have stuck that boot that you're wearing up my crack. I guarantee it.
Wait, the eggnog challenge, you wanted to lose that?
Yeah, when I say crack, I mean the crack of the table.
Footage.
I didn't mean the crack of my... I meant the crack of the table.
I bet you Annie wishes we got rid of the Santa Claus footage, though. Let's be honest with ourselves. Santa Claus is a little bit off
for you. Every day you get hit on by Santa Claus.
Annie, are you secretly happy that happened? I want to hear the truth.
I thought that was a really funny bit. My dad would love that bit like that, so...
I'm sorry, Mr. Kennedy. I really am, and I'm sorry for... blatantly telling thousands of potential viewers that I was aroused by your daughter chugging eggnog. I'm sincerely
I'm not sorry
apologize.
For anything at all.
Now he's going to love you for apologizing.
No, well,
that's
no,
still
I've
on
met
there,
the
though.
Man. I've met the man.
Yeah,
but Annie, I
want to
thank you, too.
Yeah.
And Carly didn't even take the $25. I still don't know why. Don took the $10. But
I'm not sorry for anything at all. I'm not
Annie,
sorry.
Thank you so much, sweetheart. You're a great co-host, and you came here from Seton LaSalle on pretty much a spur of the moment, and I want to thank you so much for doing it. You've been a great co-host, and hopefully we can do this on a monthly basis again. You down for that,
Definitely.
Big O, Annie?
Definitely.
Once a month on at 10 o'clock, God knows what day, you're all watching me. And Big O, buddy, thank you. One of my best friends, a great editor. And an even better friend.
Hold my hand.
And a funny guy. So, Merry Christmas, everyone.
To all a good night.
Santa's gone home.
Happy Kwanzaa.
And happy Hanukkah. What, you know,
what's
Kwanzaa?
Wait, let's just
Kwanzaa
do a little bit
like
of Santa.
Do the voice.
Which voice?
Santa.
The Santa voice.
Hey, kids, Merry Christmas.
That's
sort of like times 20.
And his boyfriend's on his way here with
Merry
shotgun.
Christmas.
I'm going to go home and slice
everyone.
My throat after this.
It's Kermit E. Frog here signing off for the Sully Show.
Maybe you can be an announcer for us in the future. They go, put him in.
All right, yeah.
Drop him
in. Record his voice.
So until next time, this has been the Sully Show. I'm Sully.
I'm Big O.
And I'm Annie.
Until next time, Merry Christmas. You behave.